Are you looking to build your own community outside of Facebook groups, Twitter, LinkedIn groups, and other social media accounts that are free and full of rules? Well, there's a new lifetime deal that's going on right now that lets you do exactly that. It's called Community with a K. Now, on this video, I will be showing you how community looks, how it works, how people sign up, and all that good stuff. And I will be talking about what I dislike about it and like about it, because there's things that are missing that I think are key to a community, but they might be coming along. So let's go jump over to my desktop to get started and show you what the deal is about. Okay, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it's called Community, like I mentioned, with a K, and it's a $49 lifetime deal. So that means you pay once and use forever. They say it's an alternative to meetup.com, Facebook, and Eventbrite. Why is it an alternative to those? Because you can create events and you can charge for those events using Community. Now, I'll talk about what I dislike about that in a bit. Let me show you what those $49 gets you, and you get access to create 3 communities, unlimited members, branded and customized community page. Now, they say it's branded, but there's the things that you can brand as of now. Now, they are coming in development. For example, there's a big logo that says community on the top left that can't be removed as of now, okay? So I'll talk about that more in a bit. And you get access to import your group from Meetup, import from Facebook, that's coming soon, unlimited online and offline events, unlimited RSVPs, and other free tickets, okay? So that's the deal, the $49 deal right now. That's the only plan. There's no license tier 2 or 3. You get everything with this. There's also the Zoom integration and all that good stuff. Now, is it hard to build a community? And the first answer is no, it's actually pretty easy. It's step by step and you can create it. And it's kind of similar to other social media feeds where you see the about, for this is an explainer, it's pretty simple for now. The wall, which is where you make your post, you can post pictures, videos, and just comments. You can make this for everyone or for members only. So that means that if your community is public, well, that's really important if you want to have public post and members only post. So right now I have it set to public. So this could be a good use case just for members, okay? And this is a example post that I made. Here's an image, some text, a day ago. I can like it, I can comment on it, I can share it. And in my case, since I posted it, well, I can copy and share it, I can post details, send the profiles, report post, and delete the post. So it's pretty simple and it looks nice. Now, let me show you what that community looks like on the public side. So I already signed up for this community, and all I did was sign up with my email and password, right? So it's pretty simple. And this is how you get started. Now, in my case, I set up so they have to fill out a form. So all I've done is sign up for a community, and this is how I get started. So you can see right here, there's a registration form. You need to answer questions before joining the community. Now we can customize our form and add these fields. This is just what I added. So for example, the name, I'll add my name right here. There we go. How did you find out about this group? It's a one question check mark right here. So I'll say Facebook, and the email, I'll just say test@test.com. This doesn't have to do anything with the registration email. So I'm asking it again, but since that's not needed, I will remove it. So I'll submit this answer. There we go. I need to reply to this email to verify, but there we go. I'm looking at this as a public view. So this is the about, the wall. Here's a post that I made. I can see the upcoming event right here. I created it also just for testing. I can like it. I can comment, test comment. Okay, I must verify the email. So, but it comments. I can share it and the options I have here, copy, share, post details, sender's profile, and report the post. If I wanted to report it, okay, so it just reports it. There's nothing to add information to it. What of these can we do? We're viewing at where is this located? I set Mexico City. There's 2 members on this. There's no way to hide that. I didn't find that option. So it's kind of discouraging when you're getting started. Once you have a bunch of members, well, that's pretty cool. You have, it's pro, view the event. So here's one of the events. I created a free event. If I click on it, there we go. Here's information. It's on the 17th of March. some tags. I can add some comments there, the attendees, and I can attend to it. This is a free one, so I'll just cancel that. There we go. So enter the event. It starts in 2 months because that's when I created. You can tie this to links where the event is going to be so they know where to go, right? Things I dislike about it. Like I mentioned, you can't change the brand. As of now, you can't change the custom domain. So right now it says community.com/SaaSmaster. So it's not white label, okay, yet. Now let me show you the roadmap of what they have coming. So this is the in progress. So Zapier integration, which is really important. I wish they add that to webhooks, which is, I think this is what they're trying to say, custom hooks. White label events and community pages with CNAME. So that means we're going to add our own custom domain. This is, they say it's coming on quarter one. This is barely January, so it might come up in a bit. Recurring events and supporting both in-person and online events. So that's in progress. Planned new design, so they're gonna make it even better. Gamification and Eventbrite integration. So that's on the roadmap. Now, let's build a community, okay? Because I have access to three with this deal. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on create. Create community, just to show you the steps. It's all going to be made up. I can import from Meetup as of now. Import from Eventbrite is coming soon, and import from Facebook. What I don't know is what type of access Eventbrite and Facebook is going to give so that actually works. I mean, is it going to send an invite to their messenger? Are they going to send an inbox to the email? So depending on the access that they're going to give, that's how it's going to work. Okay, community name, we'll just say testing for video. We'll keep it simple like that. Location, we'll say Mexico City. There we go. What's your community interest? Arts and culture. Content visibility. Like I mentioned before, you can set this to public or private. So that means that they won't be able to see the posts and the feeds and the events unless they register, which could be a good thing or a bad thing, depending what you want to use your community for. Go to community page. And here we go. Now we can go ahead and set up the information. Community settings. I'll show you the settings just so you understand what's possible and what's not possible in community. So the basic information, the description, the links for social networks. So I can also add Google Analytics, my Slack, Telegram, Discord, website URL, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, Medium. Privacy and safety, I can change it to private if I decide not to keep it public. Manage registration form. Like I mentioned before, we can create our own. I'll get to that in a bit. Joining type, free or subscription. Like I mentioned before, you can create paid events or paid memberships. And right now it's tied to Stripe from community. Okay. And they're charging a 5% fee plus the Stripe fee. Okay. But they've mentioned it on the deal right here, that they are going to change that to give us the option to add our own Stripe. So that way we are not paying like double fee, okay? So that's pretty cool, that's coming. We can change the background option for color or pattern, depending on what we want to use. Our tags, the community profile photo, and the featured photo. Okay, we're not changing anything for now. Let's go back in settings. Statistics, only for pros. We're on the pro version with the deal. We're able to view on the information for total members, events, total RSVPs, and all that good stuff. Let's go back. Manage registration form. This is where we can create our form, and we can have these options. So we can add short text, long text, single option, and multiple options, and we can make it required or not. Those are the types of options that we can add here. So once they register, they're gonna be taken, like you saw in this video, the community of the questions to start to join the community. So if they don't answer that, they can't join. So depending on the questions that you need, well, you can do it there. There's a waiting list and there's the show all answers. So you get access to all the answers also. There's also the export members. This is pretty cool because if you want to export their names and emails to send them some information via email or add them to some automation to your email marketing campaigns, etc., etc. Okay. send an email to members. You can do it from here. You can invite and do a payout. So once you start getting payments, like I mentioned before, from them, it's going to be sent over to your bank. In this case, there's no balance because I haven't sold anything. Okay, let's go back to my community. Let's go into the events just to show you how you create one. Let's create an event right here. Here we go. So what should we do? What's the event going to be about? The start date, end date, the time zone for it, the image, description. This event is going to be online. And remember, we're going to have the options later on. Event URL required. So like if it's going to be on Google Meet, it's going to be on Zoom, AirMeet, or wherever you want to send it over to. Okay. The event language, in this case, only English available. Attendee type, RSVP, ticket, no attendee limit. So if it's going to be ticket, you can do so. Attendee limit, so in case you want to limit how many people will join, so you can say 100, just in case you have some limitations where you want to do the virtual meeting. I don't know, could be an example. If you provide an email list, only users who are registered with this email address can attend. So you can limit who can attend. Approvals for attendees, who can see this event, public or those with the link, tags, and you're good to go. You publish it and it's going to be on your community wall. Okay, so if I go to community, I can see my activity feed for my communities here in single dashboard. I can explore, for example, other communities inside of community. There's the events, communities, there's talks from other people who create communities. We can see they have some successful communities around here. Messages, my communities, I can view them here. My events, my tickets, popular communities, and user suggestions. And we have that information there because it's like a community inside of community, right? Just like Facebook groups where you find other groups. Well, that happens here. I don't know how they're going to work it out once they create the white label and custom domain. So for example, on the public view, if they go to communities, the main page, they can also see the general feed. They can explore and see other communities. You might want that or not. So that's something that it's a give and take because maybe you just want to keep it private for your own community. But in this case, you can view other communities just in case something you want to have aware there. So there you go. That is the community deal. There's some good stuff and some bad stuff about it. I like how it looks. What I dislike is the things that are missing, like the custom domain. I'm not able to remove this branding on the top left and that kind of stuff. And like as of now, there's missing our own Stripe and PayPal, so we don't have to pay fees to community. So those are things to consider with this deal. The good part about it is that, I mean, if you buy it through this link right here, which I'll leave in the description, you get a 60-day money back refund policy. So that means that if you're not satisfied within those 60 days, like if they don't implement what you like in those 60 days, well, you can refund it. Or if you're good to go with what's available right now and happy with whatever comes in the future, then you're good to go with the deals that's going on right now. But there you go. Like I mentioned before, that link will be provided in the description. It's an affiliate link. So that means that if you buy through that link, it helps me out with a small commission to make these videos for you guys. Well, I thank y'all for watching. My name is George and this is SaaS Master. I'll see you guys later.